Hey guys, Kai here from TikTok2 and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to review one of Samsung's latest, the Tab S7 Plus. A big thank you to Samsung for giving us this opportunity to review this product. This tablet is marketed to be a direct competitor to the iPad Pro, and the iPad has been marketed to be a laptop replacement for years. So let us take a look at some impressive things about this tablet, the not so impressive things about it, and to see whether or not it is an overall good purchase as well as a laptop replacement. Pros: screen. Not only is this one of the nicest display on a tablet that I had ever seen, it also has a high refresh rate of 120Hz. Scrolling web pages, switching apps are all really fluid and delightful. The Super AMOLED display is running natively at 2800 by 1752, which is categorized as WQXGA+. It is as good as a 2K resolution. The screen size is 12.4 inches, so doing work on this feels like as if you're working on a 13-inch laptop. Con: there isn't a desktop plus web browser on the tablet. The iPad Pro has its native web browser, Safari, working as a full desktop class browser. So you can do pretty much all of your productivity tasks, your creativity tasks, or media consumption right on the browser without actually having an actual app running all those softwares that you want to run. Now, the Samsung Tab 7 Plus, unfortunately, they do not come with any. There is a workaround, however. You can use browsers such as Dolphin, where you can force the browser to operate on a desktop mode. But I feel that this is a downside, because this is the year of cloud computing, the year of remote working, and not having a desktop class browser is a setback for a 2020 device. Pros: specs. Wonderful specs found on this tablet. It is equipped with Snapdragon 865 Plus running Android 10. 8 gigs of RAM with 256 gig of storage. This can run 5G, so you can expect blazing fast internet speed once 5G becomes staple. My god, the battery life, 8000 milliampere on the battery life capacity. I stress test the battery life and it surprisingly runs an entire work day. 9 hours 54 minutes to be exact on a full charge. I was pretty much doing multitasking stuff on the tablet and doing some photo editing as well as simple video editing. Very, very impressive battery. You can unlock the tablet using the in-screen fingerprint sensor, so that's very convenient. I love that it is super light and very thin. It weighs only 575 grams, less than 600 grams. What? All right, there is a USB-C out, which primarily is used for charging. But of course, you can connect a USB-C hub and a lot more options are open for you. Now, with all the specs put together, this actually performs way better than my work laptop. Pro: Samsung DeX. With the new generation devices, including the Samsung S Tab 7 Plus, you get Samsung DeX Wireless. Now, prior to this, if you were to hook this up to a HDMI input, such as an external monitor or a projector, of course, with the help of a USB-C hub, you can get a desktop mode going. But now, you can do this wirelessly. Now, all you need is a monitor or a TV with a Miracast technology or equivalent for this to work. Just mirror the tablet onto your screen and you can get DeX running smoothly. DeX, wow. It is one of the biggest reasons why I am still using Samsung flagship devices, because DeX, in my opinion, it really changes the game to the entire mobile productivity work that you might do on these kind of devices because it gives you a desktop mode, which you can seriously forget that you need to do all of your productivity tasks on either Windows or Mac OS. Con, very expensive. Now this, the one that I'm holding on, this costs 1798 SGD. That is mid-tier laptop price range. And there are a lot of laptops that is of the same price or even lower, which can give you more options for productivity, for your creative work, as well as gaming. This price point is really not for everyone. But then again, if you were to compare it to the iPad Pro, it's almost the same price. So if you do really get this tablet, you really need to know how to blend it and maximize it according to your daily workflow. Pro, free stylus. Yep, free stylus. Apple, Samsung ships this stylus with the tablet for free. Apple, when are you guys going to do the same? You need to stop overcharging us. Samsung, you guys need to maintain whatever that you're doing right now. It's awesome. It's really thinking about the consumer level. Now, a little more about the S Pen. See, I have been an iPad Pro user for the entire of this year, for 2020, right? The COVID year. I use it almost every single day for productivity, for media consumption, for creative work. And 99% of the time, I use the Apple Pencil, second gen, doing all of these tasks. The Samsung S Pen somehow feels way better than the Apple Pencil Generation 2. And yes, I am not trying to, you know, curry favor with Samsung. This is the absolute honest truth from me, in my own opinion, of course. If I were to ever choose between the two, on which of these, the pen, the pencil, which I have over here, the Apple Pencil, as well as the Samsung stylus, which of these two gives me a better writing experience, I will definitely choose the Samsung. Con. The keyboard does not come together with the tablet. It is sold separately. See, I feel that to complete the entire overall experience on this tablet, you need the keyboard, which is why this is another downer, because I feel that it is super, super essential to be placed together with the tablet. This kind of situation feels like buying a laptop without a keyboard. You know, pretty much you are incapacitated. Pro, partner with Microsoft. You see, Microsoft has been a very strong partner of Samsung. They are constantly integrating productivity apps such as the Office applications into Samsung devices, which anyone who uses Microsoft can appreciate. Android is the only mobile OS that supports the Office app fully. iPad has a version of itself, but it's pretty much a watered down version. We know that the upcoming integration is going to be a whole lot better, and I really, really look forward to Microsoft having a full Microsoft team, full desktop app on an Android phone or at least a Samsung flagship phone. Microsoft, please make this happen. The current T-Mobile app on the tablet as well as the mobile phone is just way too basic. Not good. All right, verdict. Having been using this device for 2 weeks, mainly for work, I think that a tablet is closer to reaching the status of replacing a laptop. However, the main thing that is hindering that ultimate goal is the software. You can have the craziest specced up high spec hardware in a device, but you are really limited to what the software can do. And this is true for both the iPad Pro as well as the Samsung Tab S7 Plus. They are both limited by the software. But having said that, the Samsung Tab S7 Plus is a great alternative to the iPad Pro. My recommendation, if you are already entwined in the Android ecosystem, this tablet, this is for you. You really do not need the iPad Pro. This, it gives you what the iPad can, if not more. Right guys, if you do like this video, do hit the like button, and if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and hitting the bell notification button to get notified of a future video that we might post. And if I don't see you in an upcoming video before Christmas, advance Merry Christmas. All right, that's it. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.